Okay, it's time for an upgrade. I've had my old cat phone now for the last two and a half years, and the previous phone to that was also a cat phone. And I've managed, as you can see, to damage the screen, and basically the waterproofness on this phone is also not as good as it used to be because things have broken on it. So I thought I'd treat myself. And I've gone out and bought some new technology. Gone and bought a Blackview. Now, you might ask me why I've changed from cat phone to Blackview. Well, the first reason being is I contacted Cat, and I've had this phone 2 years, and they turned round to me, and when I asked them for a new screen, they said you need to send it off, and it was going to cost $208 to get repaired. I'd have to send it off to a center and I'd lose it for 3 to 4 weeks. And when you consider the software that's in this, I like to repair everything where I can. I'm not saying I'm a total environmentalist, but I don't believe you should be throwing things away which still work adequately. Now, the only two downsides to this phone is the processing power is nowhere near good enough now for a lot of the apps and everything that I use. I have to have Flir technology. Flir technology helps me repair so many things on domestic appliances. Not only am I able to film the circuit boards looking for hot spots, I'm able to look at airflows in ovens. I'm able to see the refrigeration process in action, which I'll show you in a minute, and there's a few photographs on how the refrigerant gas is going through a fridge and absorbing the warm air in the fridge and then expelling it on the hot air on the outside. And now I've got really involved in solar. The whole business here now is completely off-grid, which will be another video that's coming up shortly. And let's face the facts. This is a brick compared to the old one. But I'm also getting blind as I get older, so the text messages and everything are going to be much bigger. So I don't mind owning a brick of a phone if the screen is good enough for me to be able to see what I need to see, the processor's powerful enough, and also it has FLIR technology, which is the thermal imaging camera that's built in. So after doing a lot of reviews or reading a lot of reviews on this, I decided on this phone instead of the Doogee 98. Personal preferences. The only thing I don't like about the two phones, or sorry, the new phone, is it doesn't have an earpiece. I am going to have to buy new headphones, which are Bluetooth. But let's face it, I've got to update myself on technology eventually, so I might as well do it now while I'm wise enough to be able to understand all the literature that I need to learn to actually integrate that into the Bluetooth technology on this. It also has fingerprint recognition, I believe, and the processor is really powerful. So I'm going to update this now and transfer my SIM cards and everything. This could take me an hour, but I imagine I'll be re-recording this video in a day's time once I've managed to get it all done. But I'll show you how it all works, and we'll come back and also look at what the thermal imaging camera can do with regards to domestic appliances. Okay, I've managed to transfer all the data from my old cat phone to the new phone, and I've done it in 24 hours, transferring all the passwords, this, that, and the other. They don't quite make it as easy as I'd like, but it's acceptable. What I do miss, first thing, is I had three buttons on the bottom of my old cat phone. I do miss them because that was allowing me to toggle between screens. I'm just having to get used to the new one-screen application. It is a little bit confusing. I do like the fingerprint for accessing the machine, or I can put the password in. It allows me to do both. But the battery life I have been exceedingly impressed with. When you consider that I started filming yesterday morning
and the phone was charged. I haven't charged it, and I've been using the thermal imaging camera to make all these clips for you that you're going to see now. So the first thing we're going to do now is let's have a look at a tumble dryer and show you how the thermal imaging camera picks up the heating system, and also we'll have a look at the circuit board as well. There are many videos that I have which I've been using Flir technology, which I'll put the links in the description below on how to check refrigeration units, cookers and so on. But I'm just quickly going to show you this. I'm just loading up the Flir app now. And we've got a tumble dryer here that's stone cold, as you can see. There's no residual heat from there. And we've got the multimeter up here. And I'm just going to initiate this and turn it on, and we will actually see the heating system starting to heat up. And you can actually see that you don't even need to get a multimeter out to know that that element is heating straight away. You can already see the color temperature changing, and the temperature, if I can hold the camera steady because it is quite heavy, we're already up to 40, 50 degrees. And the temperature's climbing. That is just one way of using it. We also have the capability of looking at things like the circuit board for hot spots to check relays are working correctly or if they're failing. I'll put this little video clip up now for you to actually see. And we'll have a look also at my solar array and show you how I actually used the thermal imaging camera to check all the connections on the batteries and the connection to the inverter, the MPT controllers, and multitude of other aspects. And I also use it for solar water, because I do a lot of installations in Portugal with solar water, and we'll have a look at how the thermals work within the solar water. Now, over the last umpteen months, I've actually been turning my workshop here in Wales off-grid. And the reason why I went off-grid is the electricity prices were just going crazy. I mean, testing appliances for you on a regular basis, I was receiving energy bills in excess of £1,000 per quarter. And I just wasn't willing to continue with this uncontrolled escalation in overheads. So I actually built a 50 kilowatt storage system with 12 kilowatt of solar panels. And today is an autumn day and we've got overcast weather. It's about 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. And I'm just coming up to 3.5-4 kilowatt of energy that I'm producing here in the bottom right hand corner. At the top here, you can see my load in the workshop. I am tied to the grid, but I do not export because the electricity companies are conning everyone by paying only a minimal fee on the export tariffs. And here you can see my battery state. My battery state at the moment is 88%, which will be fully charged by the end of the day, because I've built the system in a way to really accommodate the winter. In the summer, I really do not know what I'm going to do with all the surplus energy that I produce. I don't see the point in giving it to the electricity company to sell to my neighbour at 28 pence per kilowatt when they only pay me 8 pence per kilowatt. It's a bit of a con. The Dutch have a much better system. You can export it and then take it off the grid at night. But let's just quickly have a look how thermal imaging can be used to check the whole solar array. I've done a lot of solar installations over the last couple of years in Portugal, but because I'm back in Britain at the moment, I'm having to comply with the UK regulations, which I do not have the certification for. So I'm very lucky that I've got a friend called Trevor Allen, who I went to school with, and he actually owns a company called Carbon Neutral Systems, and he actually donated a few hours of his time to actually come in, do the installation with me, commissioning the whole system. Because I'm actually tied to the grid but not exporting energy, you have to comply with all the regulations. So he was able to make sure that all the work that I was doing was done correctly. I'll put a link to his website below, Carbon Neutral Systems. I'm going to add some wind turbines to this. I'm also going to put a second array of panels in to accommodate much more for the winter, especially when we get the shorter days. This has a 50 kilowatt battery system. It's a very large system and there are hundreds of joints. I've got 48 batteries altogether. And on each of the batteries I have multiple terminals connecting these batteries up. Now the thermal imaging was able to check all my work for any dry joints, bad connections and whatever. Even to the point where the solar panels are connected, the wiring has plugs, and I'm able to check each one of these plugs with a thermal imaging camera. It's also very, very useful for if you're a plumber. You're able to check the flow from the boiler going to the radiators within seconds with a thermal imaging camera, where a conventional plumber would maybe put in his hand on the radiator waiting for it to get warm. This will spot it in seconds. You can also use thermal imaging to check your insulation on your property. You can actually go around the outside of the house on a cold day, point the camera at the windows and the insulation in the loft and so on, to actually check if you're losing energy through your building. The uses of this are incredible.
When I'm out in Portugal, I install quite a few solar water systems. Now, I normally do this very early in the morning because the roofs on the houses just get too hot. So I need to understand that the system is working correctly. Now, this was actually filmed at about 7:30 in the morning, and I'm able to see that the actual glycol, as the sun was capturing the panel, was actually going up into the heat exchanger on the tank and back down to the lower half of the panel. And I could actually see that the thermals were working correctly. I was also able to check all the insulation work that I'd done on the pipework to make sure I wasn't losing any energy. Now, I've been using this phone for 2 days and my battery life is still 40%, so I'm highly impressed with the battery. And all Flir technology cameras are brilliant if you are a plumber, electrician, you work with solar water, you're even a builder and you're using it to check the insulation. These phones are absolutely brilliant. I hope you enjoyed the video. Now I'm off to see my mother at the nursing home now. And one of the things I'm capable of doing is I can actually test my own temperature. Thanks very much indeed for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it.